know. Goddamn wicked ass piece of shit. Motherfucker don't want no answers for nothing, man. So when the Lord comes, they don't need no answers then, I guess.
I've got a scripture.
You know. They don't need the Lord, man. They need a fucking missile. They need an ICBM missile. That's the best medicine you can give any of these wicked motherfuckers. It's an ICBM missile.
I get that missile.
You believe this?
I got it. John 15 and 6. Actually, I'm gonna start at 5. I am the vine. Ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me you can do nothing. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered. And men gather them and cast them into the fire. And they are burned.
That's right.
So that's the missiles. They're going to eat those missiles.
Yeah, that's judgment. That's judgment.
That man judgment. Knows.
Oh, yeah. Hey, the scripture says you know all things.
You know so crazy. You got a little video of famous.
You know what? There was an easy mic up here when I first got here.
I don't necessarily agree with what you got here. But a white man saved my life.
Yeah, that white man could have been a brother anyway. He could have been an Israelite.
No, this is a white man. He's two doctors. You're saving from dying.
Out of curiosity, what's your point?
He's a white man.
That's your life.
I'm just saying, I don't demonize every white man. You can't do that.
Right, that's true. Yeah, I agree with you. I understand
what you say in the Bible. Everybody's not like that. I understand what you're saying. But everybody's not demonized. It's only certain people that's demonized. The ones that's in power.
This is Revelation 1 and 3. And in the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like unto the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the foot. Listen, you ain't listening. His hand and his hair were white like wool. Now, that's strike one, right?
Yeah, but
strike one, right? Was it white? Was this white like wool?
That doesn't mean.
Listen, remember when I first talked to you, I told you.
When I walked down the street,
what you say?
It's a black man I'm more scared of than him.
That's true. I agree with you.
I walked down the street in a wheelchair, and these cats want to rob me. So who are you talking about?
I used to have a patient in a wheelchair that was mercy. They were stabbing his ass. He took what little bit of nothing he had. Because he had nothing, but they took what little bit of nothing he had. His hand and his hair were white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire, and his feet like unto fine grass.
I already know all that.
This don't look like grass to me. Hey, is this grass? Is this the color of grass, anybody? Can somebody tell me if this is the color of grass?
So why are you saying
this is the goddamn devil?
I see more black devils than I see white devils.
I agree with you. I agree with you. Exactly. You know, I can't help but have fun. Don't say
that. Here it is. Put it back in there.
I was reading first back to each other. Alexander and Philip to him.
Go back to the street. Taking it to the street.
Hey, I love the Doobie Brothers.
He said like ice.
And the Doobie Brothers are brothers. The Doobie Brothers. You know about the Doobie Brothers. You know they Israelites.
What I'm saying is,
Doobie, taking it to the street.
I didn't say the streets. I said take it to the extreme.
Oh, my bad.
My bad. Where the spirit wanted the song. The spirit wanted the song to come out.
I don't know where you get a lot of your philosophy from. I think you to a certain point in philosophy. My philosophy is this. Every white man is not no devil. I see more black devils than I see white devils.
Listen to this scripture. Let me go
ahead. He can get away quick.
Let me
I'll tell you why.
This reminds me of my brother. My brother just had the same type of thing.
Listen, 9. Bro, Job 9 and 24. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked.
You're taking it out of the context.
Then break it down for us.
You are taking it out of the context
of the earth.
Break it down for us.
You're taking it out of the context.
I got the Doobie Brothers greatest hits. I'm using that when I get it. You kidding me? Man, that's some of the best music there is, man. The Doobie Brothers.
I know about the Allman Brothers. Yes, I do.
I got all this shit. I got all this shit. All this shit.
Yeah, it is.
Weekend was all motherfucking good. And he deceived the whole world.
That's in Revelation.
Black and Eve! Black and Eve! That's what he gave, Black and Eve.
Revelation 12, who started? The great dragon was cast out. That old serpent called the devil, Satan, was deceiving the whole world.
Come on.
Yeah, that dragon goes back to the starting with the ancient Roman Empire. And now, America is a continuation of the Roman Empire.
That's why everything you see written on dollar bills is written in Latin.
You know what I mean? That's the language of the Romans. Go ahead.
He was cast out into the earth, and his angels was cast out with him. And I heard a loud voice saying to heaven.
So Satan was cast out of heaven. So this is a future prophecy. It has not yet been fulfilled. Because, you know, people use that scripture to say Satan was cast out of heaven. You heard people say that. And they'll use this scripture to say that Satan was a fallen angel and all this crazy stuff. But this ain't talking about the spiritual demon Satan. This is talking about the Roman Empire. And when Satan gets cast out of heaven, that's going to be talking about the sky. Because he's going to try to fight the angels with his aircraft and his spaceship. The devil, all the governments going to battle against the angels when the angels return. They gonna get cast out of heaven. They gonna get shot out of the sky. Go ahead.
Best image of that is gonna be when they fight the angels.
Yep.
When they fight the aliens. They want no goddamn name.
The Allah Hayim.
The
aliens. You know what I mean?
Right.
I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now has come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our power and the power of his Mashiach, for the accuser of our brethren is cast down. Which accused them before our God day and night.
Yeah, because they accuse you. They make us act like we're the devil. They say what we're saying is hate speech. No, but they want to shut us down. Did he tell you about the somebody burning? I didn't see it. A church down and said it was the Hebrew Israelites that did. But they trying to set us up. Yeah. I didn't even see it. Yeah, he just now talked. I just now heard about it.
This is Revelation 12:7. And there was war in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon, and the dragon fought against his angels. He prevailed not, neither was their place found in
So that's talking about the America and NATO getting defeated by the angels. And you're wrong, bro. Randy Quaid.
Drunk ass was in the jet too. That's right. Hey, that's how desperate this devil going to be. They're going to want to hire the football team. Everybody thought he was crazy as hell.
Oh, but he came out and he came out telling you how the Jews were killing all the actors and musicians, taking their money. And he said he was in fear of his life. People say he was crazy.
He's a Jay.
Yeah, oh,
he's
yeah.
a Jay coming
up. No doubt about that. What's his name? Cousin Eddie. That's your boy.
Vacation.
Yeah. That dude's crazy.
He's only playing himself.
Let me keep reading.
Yeah. He's further down.
Yeah.
And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceived the whole world. Where was you at, though? He was at the same spot, weren't you? Yeah.
He just had to back it up and read the part where Michael cast him out.
Go ahead, read it. I got something else to back it up anyway.
Yeah, because that's talking about Esau and his government. That's why it's called the Great Red Dragon, because red is the color of Esau. You know what I mean? Scholars even called the Roman Empire the Red Dragon. That's the nickname. The Red Dragon is a nickname, or the Red Serpent. That's a nickname for the Roman Empire. Always has been. You know what I mean? People don't know that. They think that's talking about the spiritual demon Satan getting in a fight with angels. That's retarded. Because you got to understand, the book of Revelation is written in code. Because first of all, John was in prison when he wrote it. He couldn't just write down all the Roman Empire and the Caesar. They're all going to fucking die. He can't just write it down. They would have killed him. He's like, they plotting on us. You know what I mean? So he wrote it in code. He called it the Roman Empire, the Great Red Dragon, Satan, you know what I mean? That's why the whole book of Revelation, every time you see that word Satan, Great Red Dragon, that's talking about Esau and his government.
That's right.
That's a fact.
They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb.
I got Isaiah 14. So I'm going right into this too.
By the word of their testimony, and they love not their lives until death. Therefore rejoice in heaven.
Yeah, it said we love not our lives, right? The scriptures say he that loves his life shall lose it.
Just like you read the first scripture you read in the Bible. How the hell are you going to be comfortable and happy when you walk in the streets and your life is threatened by the so-called people that's put out here to protect you and your so-called brother, man? Crazy!
Shit ain't safe. That's why the Lord wrote that scripture, bro. I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. That's what we watch. This is the valley shadow of death, is right here. You don't know when you can get taken out. I almost got killed in the grocery store yesterday. Got ran over by this angry, big, just giant 300-pounder bitch. She tried to run me over, bro. I was like, bitch, you about to run us over. She just kept going. She was trying to plow through cars and everything.
Therefore rejoice, heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil has come down unto you having great wrath, because he knoweth that he hath but a short time.
Right, this devil knows his time is short. He knows that America's on his way out, and his rulership is almost over, and that Israel's about to take over. So he's going to try his hardest to come through, you know, and kill as many of us as possible.
Right, that's for a short time. Somebody's short of time. You get desperate.
They get desperate.
You get desperate.
Imagine a
man with powers that's desperate.
That's why they starting to push all these laws. They're pushing for more gun control. They bringing these race riots to fruition. The mass media is putting all that racial hatred out there. They're the ones stirring it. That's good though. We're glad it's happening. We told y'all, we already know the script. We read the script. We read it years ago.
Hey, we're telling them.
We've been known about this. We told y'all, the more people is gonna get shot by cops, and more cops is gonna get shot by people.
You know, there's a lot of shootings with cops and vice versa that's taking place in our community.
Oh yeah, there's a lot of them. So it's gonna get wild and crazy out here. Watch. And then they gonna come through They're going to start taking them guns, and eventually they're going to start microchipping everybody. Say that's the way they're going to keep you safe. Get chipped. That's the plan. You can see it coming. And they ain't stopping with their agenda. They like you said, like the scripture said, he knows he got a short time. So he's going to start moving quick. Well, watch this. Summer's going to be a long, hot summer.
That's right. A little breath, you know. And we was praying for this summer to be some terror, man, you know. You get tired of these people walking around all gossiping.
Just dumb as hell. They stuck in fantasy land.
Right. They might as well just, you know.
Yeah, which way did he go to? Which way did he go? That's the spirit they got. They got that Looney Tunes spirit.
Shut up, Chumsy.
Our people really do got that Looney Tunes spirit. You know what I mean? It's like trying to teach Daffy Duck or something. Total real. Motherfuckers bouncing all over the place, talking incoherent gibberish. That don't even make no sense when they talk.
No.
I live in Beverly Hills. I live in Malibu.
He's still, bro. He's still on fire. He on fire.
I got his ass.
That's what the scriptures do.
That's good, though. Every time we come out here teaching, that happens. There's always, it makes people go wet, go nuts.
He got that stock.
Yeah.
He got a bad case. This is Obadiah.
He got a few
one.
Others in there.
Yeah, right. A few others, right. This is Obadiah 1. Vision of Obadiah, thus said the Lord power concerning Edom. We have heard a rumor from the Lord, and an ambassador is sent among the heathen. Y'all didn't bring no more water, bro. You got cups?
Yeah, cups.
I'm going to use my cup.
Go ahead. I barely drank that.
Okay. A rumor from the Lord, an ambassador is sent among the heathen. Arise ye and let us rise up against her in battle. Behold, I have made thee small among the heathen. Thou art greatly despised.
So the Bible says Esau is greatly despised. Like you do is complaining. He's saying black people is the most evil, whatever. But the scriptures say Esau is, he's the most evil. Our people is wicked as hell, but Esau is wicked on a whole nother level. He's the supreme. He's like that super villain that you see in the comic books.
He's absolutely.
Yeah, he's that dude that wants to kill the whole world, kill everything he sees. Just a psychotic killer, you know what I mean? Cold and manipulated. Cold and calculated.
Behold, I have made thee small among the heathen, thou art greatly despised. The pride of thy heart hath deceived thee. Thou that dwellest in the clefts of the rock.
Right, his pride in his heart deceives him.
Thou that dwellest in the clefts of the rock, whose habitation is
Look at the habitation area. You know, the most expensive apartment is the penthouse. Live on that penthouse, that ain't cheap. Only Esau got money to live up there on the top.
Up at the summit.
Yeah, he got to be at the summit of the mountain, the peak of the penis.
Right, right.
Because all these buildings are like, where's the Levesque Tower? You can't see it from here, but it's actually shaped like a penis.
Whose habitation is high, that saith in his heart, who shall bring me down to the ground?
Yeah, he thinks he is unstoppable. That's why Esau is always be like, oh, America's the greatest country on earth we've ever seen. Ain't no stopping.
Jump to Amos real quick, Amos 9:2. Though they dig into hell, thence shall my hand take them. Though they climb up to heaven, this will I bring them down.
Right. And they can go make their underground bunkers and hide out. And they say they got the Rothschilds trying to hide out in spaceships too.
Yeah, we knew that was coming, yeah. That's why they there's a capsule they keep sending up. They actually named the capsule Dragon.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, Dragon, that's his name.
Dragon.
Yep. And it said it carries the heaviest, the best one that carries the most cargo. Personally, you know they already make them comfortable for the Rothschilds, or whichever ones go up there. They want to be as comfortable as they can be. And you know it's going to be decked out. I pretty much like to see it, though. I ain't bullshit.
Yeah, you know. Just like your boy Dave Rothschild had that boat, that recycled boat.
Oh, yeah, I made out of that right there.
Yeah.
That's, and it worked like a charm.
You know, it was luxurious, too, probably.
Yeah, yeah. Had probably technology to it.
Had everything in there.
Yeah, yeah. And you know, they probably got all kind of scientists that specifically study, master that type of shit, man.
Yep.
And though they hide themselves in the top of Carmel, I will search and take them out thence. And though they be hid from my sight in the bottom of the sea, thence will I command the serpent, and he shall bite them. The serpent. Is that Leviathan? Though thou, back to Obadiah, though thou exalt thyself as the eagle, and though thou set thy nest among the stars.
You see, what's the symbol of America is the eagle. The symbol of the Roman Empire is the eagle. You know, that's a proud symbol.
Right.
And Emre said it, that's, because you know, eagle is also the symbol of Jupiter.
Oh, I'm thinking about Second Ezra's left.
Yeah, that's all Jupiter. Yeah.
The Roman Empire.
It talks about the feathers of the eagle.
Yeah,
because.
Is that 11?
And that's why you see. You ever look at the Marine Corps logo? And it's got the eagle sitting right on top of the earth. Like, you know, he's running shit.
That's what it is.
The eagle globe and the anchor.
Though thou exalt thyself as the eagle, and though thou set thy nest among the stars, thence will I bring thee down, saith the Lord. If these came to thee, if robbers by night, how art thou cut off? Would they not have stolen till they have enough? If the grape gatherers came to thee, would they not leave some grapes? And that was our welfare system that Israel had back in the day. Like, we were supposed to leave, 20%? 10%? I can't
10%.
Remember. Was it 10%?
Talking about to the priest?
To the people.
Oh.
For the poor to eat.
Oh, you talking about how when you pick your crops?
Right.
Oh, yeah,
right.
You're supposed to just leave something there for them, you know what
exactly,
I mean?
Exactly.
Yeah,
because some people, you know, some people lived on the land, just moved around.
Yeah.
Just Native Americans, to be exact, you know?
Oh, yeah, because Esau, he'll take every last freaking grape or every last apple of the tree.
I've seen them.
And if you get caught stealing it, I mean, it'll lock you up.
Yeah, I've seen them dig up to bring in big-ass tractors and dig up old trees, apple trees, cherry trees, and relocate them back for somewhere else. You know?
There's actually a scripture somewhere in the Torah that says that if you're hungry, you're allowed to steal food.
Yeah. You gotta eat, man. You gotta eat. You shouldn't have a problem with that. Somebody come on your property and want to eat.
Exactly.
You know?
That's the Lord's property.
Right.
You know what I mean? So that's how this devil do it here. You born on this earth. You know, you pretty much part of the earth. We're born on it. And they gonna charge you to live on it.
That's madness.
That's madness. They charge you to live. Like I was talking to him on the way up here. I was saying, I just want to go build me a house out of adobe brick. Give me a little piece of land, give me some mud bricks, and get to building. I'll build a nice house with the quickness.
Right.
But if I did that, what would happen?
They'll lock you up, fine you, tear it down, throw you off, you know?
Because they ain't make no money off it. Because you can make a house right out the earth, naturally. Just right with you. But nah, you got to go buy their supplies and buy their bullshit.
That expensive shit.
That expensive ass bullshit that's going to fall apart.
Right. His mom, the black one, she went and remodeled her kitchen, and it's costing her up to like 15 G's. She don't care. She don't care.
These people, even if you can't, like you said, you came to live off the land. If you go fishing, they'll catch some fish to go get some food, put some food in your stomach. They'll lock you up for fishing without a fishing license.
How much is the license? $30-$40?
You can't afford that shit. All this other shit you getting charged for, you ain't got. Can't afford all these different fines and licenses. And then if you want to sell something, walking down the street, sell some CDs, oh, you might get shot for that. But if you want to sell CDs or something on the corner, you got to have a transient license, a vendor's license. If you don't get that, you can get fined and locked up for that. They don't even let you survive out here.
They catch you fishing, man, without a license.
That's serious.
They'll take your equipment.
Yeah, they take your
not
poles,
return.
Nope.
And then they fine you. A ticket.
And if you don't pay the fine, then you can possibly get locked up.
Yeah,
there's a warrant. Don't go to court.
Now they suspend your license.
Yeah, and they put warrants on everyday people. Just, I mean, there's like hundreds of thousands of people with warrants on them. It make you think, like, you hear the word warrant, you think that's like some Wild West type shit. Like, this guy's dangerous. He's dangerous. He ain't got warrants. But you get warrants over some bullshit.
You gotta say why it hurts.
Why, you forgot to use a turn signal.
They take water out of
it. Yeah, you get fined for that. Then you don't even want to drink it out there anyway. You get sick.
Yeah.
doing something, how you gonna say fuck America?
And there's a movie, man, a comedy. Those days back in the day, they was like a movie. They said something like, you have to pay for water. Somebody,
you already paying for water.
Right, right.
Like, I bought my distilled water, you know what I mean? I ain't drinking this shit out of the sink.
Man, you crazy as hell.
That shit ain't safe.
This area right now got a nitrate level, so.
Yeah. It's gross. Yeah. Old ass pipes. What is that?
They said them cops inspired by militant groups.
All you talking about? What's that channel? What channel is that over there? Channel 4? Channel 10, I mean. Yeah, but there's like a news update over here on the building.
Oh, I just realized that was
going right to Bryce Square and Scarborough. Like, this is the news. It's the real news. You know what I mean? Is that a good idea?
Zombie hell, nasty
shirt. That's a checkpoint on your ass right there.
It's sure old.
What's up, bro?
It didn't look like a Michael J. Fox with a beard.
Not the dude on Married with Children.
Oh, you talking about Bud?
Bud. That's what it looked like.
Bud, Bud.
Looked like Bud, man.
That could be Bud, Bud. Right. You got all bugged out.
Bud, Bud. Yeah, I heard he was actually a cool motherfucker.
Oh, he's got, yeah, I've seen the baby party. He's got all the women.
Right. How are the things that we saw searched out? How are Jim F. said it on? Bill Murray was a cool motherfucker.
Oh, yeah, he's gotta be.
Yeah, he said he was a cool ass boy, motherfucker. Gave him tights and everything, man. Paid
Bill,
him some money.
Bill Murray, Caddyshack?
Yep.
Ghostbuster? Hey, Ghostbuster, bro, that's the movie.
They said he was a homie.
He looked like he would be, because he's a real smart ass, too. I can relate to that, you know what I mean? Talking shit. He's a good shit talker. That's a trait of Israel, being good at talking shit.
How are the things that he saw searched out? How are his hidden things sold up? All the men of thy confederacy have brought thee even to the border. The men that were at peace with thee have deceived thee.
Yeah, because we see everything that Esau is doing. That's how all of his sins have been searched out. Like, you be going into the Illuminati, all these secret societies. We've been telling y'all that these race riots are being stirred up, and how a lot of these shootings out here are false flags set up by the CIA. We know about all that. Everybody knows about it now, it seems like, on the internet. The conspiracy theory videos are everywhere.
They're going crazy with it.
Exactly.
The men that were at peace with thee have deceived thee and prevailed against thee. They that eat thy bread have laid a wound under thee. There is none understanding in him.
None.
Shall I not in that day, saith the Lord, even destroy the wise men out of Edom and understanding out of the mouth of Esau? And thy mighty men, O Teman, shall be dismayed to the end that every one of the mouth of Esau may be cut off by slaughter.
Esau is going to be slaughtered.
For thy violence against thy brother Jacob, for thy violence against thy brother Jacob, shame shall cover thee.
You just see that with a police shoot. You know what I mean? But not just police shooting. It goes way deeper than that. They sitting there forcing vaccinations on people. Like, we just telling you that the water ain't safe to drink. They purposely putting shit in the water to make you retarded. Go ahead.
And thou shalt be cut off forever. In the day that thou stoodest on the other side, in the day that the strangers carried away captive his horses, and foreigners entered into his gate, and cast lots upon Jerusalem. That brings me to mind of
casting lots.
Trying to tighten that spaceship.
Yeah,
they did too.
Because they came in and they took all their money and their took all their gold and just took everything down. And they robbed the temple and took it back to Rome.
Right. All this rich, thick gold. Entered into the gates and cast lots upon Jerusalem. Even thou was as one of them. But thou shouldest not have looked for the day of thy brother the day that he became a stranger. Neither shouldest thou have rejoiced over the children of Judah.
Oh, I see, on the day that his brother became a stranger. What does that mean? About how, you know, Israel got jacked up and got scattered among the nations, became like strangers and Gentiles. And then Esau mocked us for that, made fun of us for that. That's more proof that Israel scattered right there.
Right, what was that? Was that a... coming out of Egypt when we was trying to go through the Atlantic.
And they blocked us.
Right, right.
I can get that.
That's a vicious shit, man. And we told them we're coming through in peace. You know?
Yeah.
I can't remember if they mentioned not having arms or whatever. So, been the devil. And the devil is. Go watch. It's the same thing they do when you go watch Dublin, New Albany,
yeah, they won't let
Worthington. The cops go right behind you. There's a video of this black woman walking through a white neighborhood. The white woman told out, yeah, right, man. She smacked the shit out of her. They literally act like they own this goddamn land, man. Of course, that's why they name the lands after their own selves. Goddamn devils. Okay, but thou shouldest not have looked for. But thou shouldest not have looked on the day of thy brother in the day that he became a stranger. Neither shouldest thou have rejoiced over the children of Judah in the day of their destruction. Neither shouldest thou have spoken proudly in the day of distress. Though thou shouldest not have entered into the gate of my people in the day of their calamity. Yea, thou shouldest not have looked on their complaint. In the day of their command. He jumped on it without no hesitation. Thou shouldest not have looked on their affliction in the day of their commandment, nor have laid hands on their substance in the day of their commandment. That sounds like he had niggas with him too. Nigga love going to what they call it. Well, when they be riding, they go into stores and start taking shit. What they call that? The word for that? Loot. Yeah. Yeah. It sound like Esau had Jake with him.
Esau did use Jake.
I can
Jake
imagine
club.
Niggas too, man.
That team went with Esau.
You mind dog?
What do you think Alexander the Great did?
You mind dog?
Alexander the Great, he had a lot of Jakes in his army. Same thing
that's
with the Romans. The Romans too.
Yeah, that's why they read the scholarship.
They even tell you there's a famous saint too. His name was what was his name for Egypt? Saint Moore. You know what I'm talking about? Saint Moore's. Hold on, I'll look it up. He was a martyr. He was in the Roman legions.
Oh, yo.
Is it Saint Moore?
No.
How do you say it? Saint Moore or something? But his name means black. But he was a famous, Saint Maurice.
Yes,
Saint Maurice. Come on, maybe Maurice Moore, same thing.
I'm thinking of somebody else.
But he was an Israelite. He was in the Roman legions, and he refused to renounce the Lord, so they killed him for it. And he became a martyr, and you know, the church said he was a saint. Look at that. And he was heralded all through Europe and all through the Roman Empire.
Neither shouldest thou have stood in the crossway. That's it. In the crossway. That's what you're looking for still.
Huh?
14 right. Says, neither shouldest thou have stood in the crossway to cut off those of his that did escape. Just give a reference to what we was reading about it. But that was that's like when they besieged Jerusalem, the Romans came to Jerusalem, some of us did escape. Some of us fled into the interiors of Africa. Some of us went further up into Europe. All those lands. I wish I had a map, man.
Yeah, they went all through the Mediterranean.
I could bring no map.
I got this. This goes in with them with Esau too. This is Exodus 17:8. Then came Amalek and fought with Israel and Rephidim. And Moses said unto Joshua, choose us out men and go out, fight with Amalek. Tomorrow I will stand on top of the hill with the rod of the Most High in my hand. And Joshua did as Moses had said to him and fought with Amalek. And Moses, Aaron, and Hur went up to the top of the hill. And it came to pass when Moses held up his hand that Israel prevailed. When he let down his hand, Amalek prevailed. But Moses' hands were heavy. Oh, I'm just saying, bro. Oh, no, this is right. Let me just get down to it. Actually, I'll just read it all. Moses' hand was heavy, and they took a stone and put it under him. And he sat there on it, and Aaron and Hur stayed up his hands, the one on the one side and the other on the other side. And his hands were steady until the going down of the sun. They kept his hands. And Joshua discomfited Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword. So that's how Joshua thought about Esau, with the edge of the sword. And the Lord said unto Moses, write this for a memorial in a book and rehearse it in the ears of Joshua, for I will utterly put out the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven. And Moses built an altar and called the name of it, well, it says Jehovah Nissi. That's probably around way different.
Sir.
Hold on 1 second, bro. Look, for he said, because Yahweh has sworn that Yahweh will have war with Amalek from generation to generation. That's a good scripture, right? From generation to generation. I mean, never ending. Oh, also the end of the earth. I got another precept to back it up. It is talking about forever.
Like scripture
probably
says,
oh, hand.
With Esau. Right, right. The wicked shall not go unpunished.
So that's a doctrine of Satan right there.
Right, right.
I got it right here. You got it? Or you want to get it?
You
know,
you can forget your enemy that's so much that's done and still going, so much affliction on us.
Right. Here we go right here. Deuteronomy 25 and 17. Remember what Amalek did unto thee by the way when you were come forth out of Egypt, because you wouldn't let us pass. He's trying to escape from Deuteronomy 25. Deuteronomy, the first one was the Exodus. This one was Deuteronomy 25. You want to read it? Amalek did unto thee by the way when you were come forth out of Egypt, how he met thee by the way and smote the hindmost of thee, even all that were feeble behind thee. Yeah, because Esau, he'll kill the people, the children, the women, you know what I mean?
Yep, and then rape the dead bodies.
Yeah, yep. That were feeble behind thee when thou was faint and weary, and he feared not the Most High. Therefore shall it be, when Yahweh, thy Alahaya, hath given thee rest from all thy enemies round about in the land which the Yahweh Alahaya giveth thee, for the inheritance to possess it, that thou shalt blot out the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven, thou shalt not forget it. It's hard to read, it's all the madness out here. So yeah, so the Lord, he gonna blot out the remembrance of Amalek. Oh, you didn't finish Obadiah.
I still got it, bro.
It says the same thing as Obadiah.
I still got it. And it ain't going nowhere.
And the New Testament doesn't speak so kindly about Esau either.
Here we go back to Obadiah 14. Neither shouldst thou have stood in the crossroads to cut off those of his that did escape.
Oh, see, look. That's the same thing. He's remembering what happened after the Exodus.
Neither shouldest thou have delivered of those of his that did remain in the day of their
death. And look, that was hundreds and hundreds of years after the fact. And the Lord didn't forget. There ain't no statute of limitations. He's like, look, I'm still going to get you for what y'all did hundreds of years ago during the Exodus. Which that was really like, that was probably 500 years before this was written right here. You know what I mean? And the Lord stood it again.
Oh, yes.
Did you think that Exodus was around what, 1400 BC? Oh, you're talking about,
Requiring that which is past. That's not 12.
Requiring that. Yes, in Ecclesiastes. You got it?
I got it. Ecclesiastes 3 and 15.
Oh, yeah.
That which hath been is now, and that which is to be hath already been. And the Most High Yahweh, Hashem Yahweh Shai, requires that which is past.
Yeah, it requires that which is past, because there's no new thing under the sun anyway. That the Lord don't change. If you commit a crime today, you gotta pay for it tomorrow.
My thing is this, man. I'm serious.
What's the championship? What's the wrestling team?
Nobody know what Jesus looked like, man.
Come here, bro. Come here.
Nobody know what Jesus looked like.
Listen, bro. Let's give you some understanding so you can get on fire. Revelation 1 and 14.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
Now, in order for you to describe somebody, you're going to describe them, right?
Yeah.
Say it again.
His head and his hair were white like wool.
You know who wrote Revelation? Apostle John. He was a black man. He was on the island of Patmos serving slavery as a salt mines, right? So the Most High gave them a vision. So when the Most High came and delivered them back in the day, their visions were, you were placed right there like a hologram. They were actually there, like, damn, you know, and got scared because they thought they was in it. So the Most High sent the apostle a vision, and he was looking at the Lord, you know? And he saw the Lord had woolly hair. So go on, man.
That's right. That's snow. And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
He was watching the Lord. He saw his eyes because the Lord drank wine. And his eyes were red, like flame of fire, like the scripture says, because he drank wine. And your eyes, the white of your eyes turn red from wine. You know, not the black part, but the white. Go ahead.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
So in order for him to see somebody, and he's named the color, fine brass, the color of brass, when you got a penny. So he saw the Lord. You know? He saw him.
So are y'all like Israelites?
We the Hebrew Israelites, right? We the real ones though. We the real prophets.
What about the other dude?
Them is false. Them people are doing their job. Their job is to deceive. To deceive. Because the Lord is not coming to save black people. Because if you out, when the Lord does return, when all this hell breaks loose, and you still walk around calling yourself a black person, a black man, or an African, or African American, the Lord ain't gonna deliver you. The Lord's coming to save his people that know they are Israelites. And you are a Jacob. Jacob's just a slang word we use for Jacob. Jacob was progenitor of the 12 tribes of Israel. That's Jacob. That's all of Jacob right there, you know?
That I believe.
I'm gonna get a scripture for
it. That I believe.
See, they teach you in these churches that nobody's seen them because it don't serve their purpose to teach that the Lord was black, because these churches want to bring in as many people as possible that
you got money.
It's a
business.
It's a racket.
Especially the guys you seen in purple.
They all get them dudes.
They just want your money.
They just want them the time of day when they see me down here.
Even if you did ask them a question, they ain't gonna answer them anyway.
Nah, they ain't got no.
Have you noticed that?
Yeah. You know? Me and my girl, we try to ask them. Then they talking about they don't listen. You're a lot listening to rap music and smoking. We seen them smoking weed and listening to rap music and shit.
There it is, bro. See, the scripture says, do as they say, but don't do as they, you know, don't follow after what they do. You know what I'm saying? Because they say follow the law, but none of them motherfuckers is following the law. Follow the law.
We are supposed to follow the law to the best of our ability.
Because you can't, you know, you do have power and control over what you can follow. For example, like a food diet, which is the number one thing that Israelites cannot change for some reason. You tell somebody to stop eating pork, yeah, cuss your ass out, man.
Like bacon?
You mean no more pepperoni sausage?
Yeah.
Wait a minute, I eat chitlins. We eat some chitlins.
They'll stop talking to you just because of that.
Right. Yeah. You get disowned.
Yeah, my sister, I don't know what it's called when they go to church on Saturdays, but they don't eat pork.
Okay. Or it's just on that day?
Yeah, it's just on that day. Maybe have every other day. The Sabbath, maybe like Sabbath on Saturday?
Yeah, right. That's not even biblical either. Yeah. You know, the Sabbath falls every, you know, I mean, it's different. Because the moon, you know how the moon, how the new moon is, you know, it's always different. You know, so it ain't going to be always Friday sundown and Saturday sundown. It's going to come on different days. Like this, what was it? It was Saturday sundown or the Sunday sundown? This last one. Next time it might be on Wednesday. It's never the same, man. You know? But this devil is only doing what he set them ones up in red, he set the ones up in purple to keep the people stuck on stupid, man. You know? Because we're going to teach you the scriptures.
I got a precept.
We're going to teach you the scriptures and go out and cut these churches and cut them. That's why when we come out here, when they out here, they pack up right away and leave. You know? Because we got the cameras to show you that they ain't got no wisdom and understanding. So they don't have no business being out here teaching the Bible. You know? They don't have no business, man. You know?
They teaching the mark of the beast is Christianity.
You hear about the mark of the beast? You familiar with it?
So soon the government gonna start microchipping people. They gonna put microchips in. And they'll tell you that we're conspiracy theorists and that the UN have to work. There's no. They'll
say checking device or something.
Yeah, and that, exactly. They'll tell you because the leader of their church, he's a detective for the NYPD.
For who's the
dudes in the purple?
Oh, for real?
Yeah, he actually works for the government. And he'll tell you that the microchip don't exist.
So, I mean, why are they trying to put that in motherfuckers?
Well, they're creating the situation. They're creating the whole thing so that you will have to get it. So, eventually, you see, right now, there's an economic crisis on Earth right now. Okay? And it's just escalating, getting worse and getting worse. So, eventually, they're going to crash the system over the whole Earth. They're going to crash the system, and they're going to create a cashless society. So, you won't be carrying around big bills. And you ain't going to be carrying around credit cards anymore. That's where this come in at. It's gonna be a cashless society, so that ID, that RFID chip is gonna have all your information. If you were a criminal, it's gonna have your information from your criminal past. Yep. If you're sick and you need certain medications, it's gonna be programmed in the chip what you need, what you're allergic to. You know, if you're on the run,
your car ain't even gonna start without it.
That's right.
You won't be able to get on a code bus, no EBT. You ain't gonna get nothing without this chip.
Because it has you're gonna need it for. It's gonna have your how much money you have. But check it out. This is all scriptural, man. This is all scriptural.
Because you see, when you get a job now, they already try to get you to go direct deposit.
Yeah.
You know,
they don't really like you
getting cash.
Yeah. Here you go. This is Revelation 13 and 15. And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak. It calls that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. Because that's where it's coming down to. Because there's going to be people that's going to, no matter what, they ain't going to get that chip. But they're going to be put to death. And there are some people that's going to escape. The Lord might deliver them. Or they might escape just to get burnt up in a nuclear missile. What's coming, man, the Lord is bringing all hell on this earth.
It's already started.
That we sit here telling you that even we know what's coming down, we can't describe it in the full. But it's going to be horrible.
You see, they already started shooting the cops. More cops are getting shot every day, man.
What, you seeing how the cops are shooting?
Good!
That's what I'm saying.
Did you see the one video? The cops had his knee on the dude's head, pulled his gun out.
I heard about it on the news, though.
There's a video.
You ain't see the one where you talk about his wallet and the baby girl?
Yeah.
There's going to be more of it, though.
It's supposed to be this way. Why do you think the Lord got to come deliver us? Because all hell is going to escalate, get worse.
They ain't
going to
install martial law. It's going to get crazy out here.
He doesn't. I can go back. Okay. And he calls it all. And he calls it all. Both small and great.
Right,
listen, brother. This is for you, too.
You don't need to go there.
He's already got a few ten chips.
I'm old school. You haven't told me. I'm not
going to. He probably can change his.
You know what?
What's up, bro?
The man is right. A lot of things I don't agree with you.
What don't you agree with, bro? You got to get understanding.
Hey, I got to make this money, though, man.
I feel you. Right, hey, right. Hey, but we out here every Sunday, man. 2-3 o'clock. Okay. What's your name, sir? That's his name.
That's Hebrew.
That's Hebrew. That's Hebrew.
You nice Hebrew, too?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Oh, he's a Hebrew. He's
a lot of things can do for
you. I don't know if he accepted that.
No,
that's what I'm saying. They all know they Hebrew. He's going to come out and tell you. Okay, we see you, man.
That I agree with you.
You gotta be able to reason with people. You gotta be able to.
That I agree with you.
Speak reason with
people. You tell us what you don't agree.
They don't believe that a white man is a devil.
I just don't agree with that.
How about we kick it? Would that make you feel better?
Man, I'm gonna tell you something. What? I lost my leg in a car accident 25 years ago. Okay. It was white. There was two white doctors that saved my life. No, and but for them, I'd be dead.
They could be
whatever.
We already explained that, bro.
They can be jinxed. Let me finish this. And he calls us all.
When the Most High set up killers and stuff in places, you know what I mean? Just take your ass. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And he calls us all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads.
You want to put it down, man. Put it down.
And that no man might buy or sell, save he that has the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is a number of a man, and his number is 666.
So that's why these people ain't ready for. They ain't ready. You see what's gonna happen when they start microchipping people. They gonna have, they got a, the way they control society by a principle known as problem, reaction, solution. Now they got the problem. Too many cops are killing people, and too many people's killing cops. So the riots is gonna break out. They gonna come through and they gonna act like they the savior to stop the riots. You know what I mean?
Damn.
When the riots break out, people gonna be begging and pleading, oh, where's the police? Come and save me. 911 don't work. Yeah. Yep. That's how you do it.
Proverbs 12 and 10. A righteous man regardeth the life of beasts, but the tender mercies of the wicked are cruel. He that telleth his land shall be satisfied with bread, and he that followeth vain persons is void of understanding.
Yeah, following your boy Nathaniel, that's a vain person, following Alizé. That's a that dude's super vain. That dude, Alizé. He's a supreme vanity. He called himself Adrian Adonis or something. Like he was beautiful or something. Like.
And that's the wrestler, the fag wrestler.
Oh, no. Adrian Adonis. No, it was Adonis Delirious. But yeah, that reminds you of Adrian Adonis, don't it? Like the gay old dudes. Yeah.
He was bad. That was my boy when he was before his
fag. Oh, yeah. That was back in the old school wrestling. They out there, I mean, you ain't supposed to mix all them steroids with all that cocaine. That's a bad mix.
Wicked desires. The
net
evil man, but the root of the righteous, you're the fruit.
Yeah, the root of the righteous, and the root of the righteous is Yahweh. You know what I'm saying? He's the tree, he's the vine, we're the branches. Like we read it earlier. If you don't, whoever does not abide in Yahweh, then they don't bear no fruit. We can't do nothing without Yahweh. You know, man.
I got it. This is absolute must. This is Isaiah 30 and 1. Woe to their rebellious children, saith the Lord.
That's a good scripture.
That take counsel, but not of me. And that cover with a cover, but not of my spirit. That they may add sin to sin. That walk to go down into Egypt, and have not asked at my mouth.
Yeah, oh, that's even... Like these people out here, they want to be part of America. They're a great American. They live a good. I'm a good citizen. I'm a proud taxpayer, proud American. You know, you know this bullshit.
Taxpayer.
How
you can
be proud to pay taxes? You're getting taxed, and you're proud of getting taxed. If you look at the definition of tax, that means to get beat, to get worn out. That's what it made you like, yeah, I'm feeling taxed, bro. I'm spent. Get it?
To strengthen themselves in the strength of Pharaoh.
The strength of the Pharaoh. The modern day Pharaoh is President Obama and the president.
Barack.
As you see, looks on the back of a dollar bill is a pyramid. They paying homage to the ancient Egyptian gods. okay? Because America is spiritually known as Egypt. It's spiritually known as Sodom and Gomorrah.
And to trust in the shadow. Therefore shall the strength of Pharaoh be your shame, and the trust in the shadow of Egypt your confusion.
He still got people saying Obama's doing a good job. And they are saying he's the best president of all time now. They gonna take Lincoln out and put him up on Rushmore.
They do that with $20 bills.
They should just put Obama on it. Shit, that's what I said.
There's a big ass rebellion that money.
There is though.
When it happens, it's gonna happen.
Yeah, people said they gonna burn all their money and everything. So that's good, man. It's just more division. It's just prophecy coming to pass.
Got them poles. Got them poles fishing.
Oh.
What you catch, man?
We fishing
too.
Do
you love
it? Oh, hell yeah.
Who the
heck is
this? This dude gone.
They going fishing for apartments.
They'll eat that too.
That's good. They love it.
They fishing in the Scioto. You ain't supposed to. Even the city tells you not to eat nothing out of the Scioto.
They go in it. They go in it. Because I see them all the time. When I ride by, I can't remember that road down there by the park where they're playing baseball. They be out of the water.
Because
every year somebody's drowning out there because they got in the water.
You go out here right by Dodge Park. There's people everywhere.
Go in the water, man. The most filthiest water, and it stinks.
Yeah, yeah, you ain't gonna just, you can't get too close to this thing. You see turds floating?
Right, right.
They gonna eat that.
Isaiah 31 and 3. Now the Egyptians are men and are not God, and their horses flesh and not spirit.
The Israelites are gods, you know. Even though when he's saying the bottom line, the Israelites are gods.
And we are gods.
Wicked ass men.
Hey, there's a scripture where I think the Philistines called us gods.
You see them bones they dug up? They found the Philistines. I ain't read it yet, though. I saved it, though, so I can go back and read it.
You're not talking about giants, are you?
I don't know. I saw it when I woke up this morning.
I heard about that, yeah.
You know, the first thing that popped up, I was going to save it so I can read the paper. They found some bones of burial ground or something of the Philistines, man. So I'm kind of curious to see the bones. And we already know the Philistines are tall.
Yeah, they... Well, say, yeah, just like the Egyptians were told too, because they was related to the Egyptians.
And Yahweh shall stretch out his hand. Both he that helpeth shall fall, and he that is holding shall fall down, and they all shall fall together.
And they must help the hold the motherfuckers enlisting in the military. This motherfuckers enlisting in the military is in an all-time mode. So they're going to have to start a riot. There's going to be motherfuckers. You see those people walking around with the green. They got CCCP in their shirt.
Yeah.
Security
the community. Citizens on patrol.
Right.
And
doing their job.
They look like a bunch of nerds. Yeah, fucking weirdos. Right. They're always like some Edomites, too.
Yeah, right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
It's like, oh, I see you guys over there selling drugs. Want to get you. Flashlight and shit.
Right, right. And I think they got mace, too. Wow.
Yeah, I hope they start giving, like, Lord willing, the Lord's going to put terror on y'all, too, man.
Yeah, they're going to get them.
I'm tired of y'all even looking at me. Yeah, they walk around thinking they got some power.
Some authority. They got some authority.
Look like fucking losers, man.
I feel like that.
It reminds me of that. You ever seen that movie, How High? It reminds me of that that little college. Yeah, dude. Remember that little nerdy ass cop? He was trying to write him tickets. Oh, man. Yeah. I mean, his bike. Oh,
yeah. Boots and shit. That was a funny ass movie, too.
That was back in my foolish days when I was watching that. That was late, early 2000s. I can't find that scripture, man. Where the, I think it was the Philistines called Israelites gods. Is it in Joshua or Judges? Yeah, maybe that's it. I don't think that's what I was. Maybe it is actually.
If we knew, if we,
I'm not worried about it.
In a correct manner, they knew all power would be behind us. You know, they knew that, man. And they knew when we going off, they knew when to attack us. Also, they had intelligence.
Yeah, because that's in the Apocrypha, referring to Judith. And the dude tried to give the king counsel. And he's like, no, if the Lord is with them, you cannot attack them. You know where that's at? That's in Judith. We'll go read a whole book of Judith. You'll see. Yeah, that's a good one. Man, we should find that one, actually. Let's see if I can dig that out. The Judith is a really good book, man. That'd be a, now that would make a good movie, wouldn't
it? Yeah. The parties moved up.
Oh, yeah.
They already think they're the parties.
Oh, they be the hero. No, don't make Judah.
Because you know they'll butcher it, man.
They'll butcher it.
They'll butcher it, man. They'll have Judah cooking, cleaning chitlins.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
She be running, commanding the whole army. You know what I mean?
Yeah, with a dagger and a hole of sword.
She'd be taller than everybody.
A heavy 30, 40-pound shield. Yeah. Throwing that shield like Captain America, boomerangs. Imagine that, man. Yeah, we gotta erase that part out the camera, man. Just making a Judah movie. That might be, because these devils watch our videos, man.
Oh, yeah, they're gonna go.
They watch our videos, man. And a lot of people that's in Hollywood watch them and listen to them. Are listening to the prophets and they're taking ideals out of what the prophets say.
Shit, I still ain't seen that good King David movie yet. Where's that at? They made Richard Gere's King David. But that's a slap in the face. Richard Gere? How was that King David? King David was the mightiest man that ever lived. The mightiest warrior. He killed tens of thousands of people and they gonna have Richard Gere play King David.
They say Alexander.
Nah, King David killed way more than Alexander. Hell no. He is up there among the great warriors. He's probably like fifth place. I don't know. And now he did kill a lot though. He took out the whole Persian army. But he had help from the angels too. Yes, that's true, because there's ancient accounts that there was chariots that was flying over the battle between Alexander and the Persians. So you're like, he had help from the heavens. Even the Lord helped out the devil just to fulfill his prophecies. Because it was Persia's time was up. Because Daniel prophesied about the four beasts. You know what I'm saying? First you had that Babylonian beast. Then you had the Persian beast. Then after the Persian beast, you had the Macedonian beast with Alexander. You know what I mean? And the Alexandrian Empire. And then the last and final beast was that great beast.
That was the leopard.
Yeah, the leopard. The last beast was that great dragon that was iron teeth. And that was the Roman Empire. That was the mightiest beast of them all.
Deuteronomy 28 and 10. And all people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of Yahweh, and they shall be afraid of thee.
Oh, that's a beautiful scripture.
This bad. Yeah. Who was that? Some other nations, they dumb, they some foolish, wicked people. But they knew if we'd fallen off, they knew to attack them. Just like with Balaam wanted to go after the part where, you know, before the party got to when he kept striking his ass.
Yeah, yeah.
But, mobike that wanted to come and go and destroy it. I'm tripping. I don't even remember if it was a mobike.
Yeah, I think it will. Talking about, that's the, remember that said no witchcraft from Belgium, Jacob? I'm still trying to find this one in
Jewish.
I gotta read the whole book this
week. Oh, right. You gotta scan it.
Yeah. Yeah, it was what Holofernes was trying to give counsel. Yeah, I can't. I'm just about to read that later. Y'all just need to go read the Book of Judas, and you can see that the general, he was afraid because he knew that the Lord was with Israel at that period in time, and he knew that he was not going to prevail. You know what I mean?
Yeah, Balaam was an Israelite. The children of Israel set forth and pitched in the plains of Moab, and on the side of Jordan by Bethlehem. And Balak the son of Zippor, saw all that Israel had done to the Amorites.
That nigga
coming down the cut, talking crazy.
There's too many spirits out here.
And Moab was sour afraid of people because they were
men. What I'm saying is,
Moab was distressed because
we
children.
We got you. Hold on, Brother Reed. Let Brother Reed, we in the middle of something.
And Moab said unto the elder of Midian, now shall this company pick up all that are around about us, as an oxen pull up the grass in the field. And Balak the son of Zippor was capable of the Moabites at that time. He sent messengers, therefore, unto Balaam the son of Beor, the Pethor, which is by the river of the land of the children of the people, to call him, saying, behold, there is a people that come out from Egypt. Behold, they cover the face of the earth, and they abide on you against me. Come now, therefore, I pray, curse me this people, for they are too mighty for me, and peradventure I shall prevail, that we may smite them, and that I may drive them out of the land, for I walk that he whom thou blessest is blessed, and he whom thou cursest is cursed.
Yep.
And the elder of Moab and the elders of Midian departed with the words of the divination in their hand, and they came unto Balaam, and spake unto him the words of Balaam. And he said unto them, lodge here this night, and I will bring you word again, as the Lord shall speak unto me. And the princes of Moab abode with Balaam. And the Most High came unto Balaam and said, what men are these with thee? And Balaam said unto them, Balak the son of Zippor, king of Moab, has sent unto me, saying, behold, there is a people come out of Egypt, which covers the face of the earth. Come now, curse me them. Peradventure I shall be able to overcome them and drive them out. And the Most High said unto Balaam, thou shalt not go with them. Thou shalt not curse the people, for they are blessed. So obviously, that's what they're talking about. Very great honor, and I will do whatsoever thou sayest. Come therefore, I pray thee, curse me this people. Balaam answered and said, I see the servant of Balaam. Balaam will give me this house full of silver and gold. I cannot go beyond the word of the Lord, my power and your hour, to do less or more. Now therefore, I pray you, tarry, be also here this night, that I may know what the Lord will say unto me more. And the Most High came unto Balaam that at night and said unto him, if the men come to call thee, rise up and go with them, but yet the word which I shall say unto thee, thou shalt do.
You guys are taking things out of context, man.
And Balaam rose up in the morning and saddled his ass and went with the princes of Moab. And the anger, and the Most High's anger was kindled because he went.
want to do that because you'll get jacked up. When the Lord is with Israel, you can't mess with Israel. They're unstoppable.
That's right.
Oh, remember when the Most High sent Israelite spies to go spy out the land?
Yeah.
They was all afraid.
It's around the time with the whore.
Yeah, well, yeah.
Hold them out the window.
Because they came back with an evil report saying that the people in that land is too great.
Right.
And the Lord said, if I tell you you're going to fight, you can go fight.
Right.
Joshua and Caleb was the only ones that were not scared. What are you talking about?
Oh, my shit did? How my shit done? Oh, I had a comb before we even got out here. Wow, my shit did.
I appreciate about the art. 1 Samuel 5. None. It was so that after they had carried it away, the hand of Yahweh was against the city with a very great destruction, and he smote the men of the city, both small and great, and they had emeralds in their secret parts. Therefore, they sent. What's that shit? It's like something, like some, like a bump in the ass or something. I don't know. It's like hard shit or something. What are you talking about?
Yeah. Your innards. Go ahead.
Therefore, they sent the ark of God to Ophron, and it came to pass that the ark of God came to Ophron, and the Ophronites cried out, saying, "They have brought about the ark of our God, of the God of Israel, to us to slay us and our people." So they sent and gathered together all the lords of the Philistines, and said, "Send away the ark of the God of Israel, and let it go again to his own people, that it slay us not, and our people, for there was a deadly destruction throughout all the city. The hand of God was very heavy there, and the men that died not were smitten, the inroads, and the cry of the city went up to heaven." And the ark of Yahweh was in the country of the Philistines.
Same thing.
7 months, and the Philistines called for the Christ, the priest and the diviner, saying, "What shall we do to the ark of Yahweh? Tell us wherewith we shall send it to his place." And they said, "If he sent away the ark of the God of Israel, send it not empty, but in any wise return him a trespass offering, that he shall be healed, and it shall be known to you why this his hand is not removed from him." Then said they, "What shall be the trespass offering which we shall return to him?" They answered, 5 golden inrods, 5 golden mice, according to the number of the Lord of the Philistines. For one plague was on all the lords, on your lords.
Look, you got something? Go ahead, I got it.
I'm still trying to find this one.
All right, let me read this. Well, we reading the long scriptures now, so y'all gotta bear with us, but we gotta get it in. Judith 5:1. "Then was it declared to Holofernes, the chief captain of the army of the sword, that the children of Israel had prepared for war and had shut up the passages of the hill country and had fortified all the tops of the high hills and laid impediments in the champaign countries. Whereas he was very angry and called all the princes of Moab and the captains of Ammon and all the governors of the sea coast, and said unto them, Tell me now ye sons of Canaan, who this people is that dwelleth in the hill country, and what are the cities that they inhabit, and what is the multitude of their army, and wherein is their power and strength, and what king is set over them or captain of their army? And why have they determined not to come and meet me more than all the inhabitants of the west?" Because Israel's like, y'all can go to hell. You know what I mean? You know, Israel's stubborn. They ain't like the other nations. They tell you, they thought Assyria was so powerful, but they told them to go, pretty much go fuck yourself. We ain't bowing down to you. And it said, "Accuser, the captain of the sons of Ammon, let my lord now hear a word from the mouth of thy servant, and I will declare unto thee the truth concerning this people which dwelleth near thee and inhabiteth the hill country. And there shall no lie come out of the mouth of thy servant. These people," Satan, "these people are descended of the Chaldeans." Well, that's talking about, you know, because Abraham came up out of Mesopotamia, right? And they sojourned here too in Mesopotamia, because they would not follow the gods of their fathers, which were in the land of Chaldea. For they left the way of their ancestors and worshiped the God of heaven, the God whom they knew. So they cast them out from the face of their gods, and they fled into Mesopotamia and sojourned there many days. Then their God commanded them to depart from the place where they sojourned and to go to the land of Canaan, where they dwelt and were increased with much gold, silver, and with very much cattle. But when famine covered all the land of Canaan, they went down to Egypt and sojourned there. And while they were nourished and became there a great multitude, so that one could not number their nation, because Israel was mighty. Therefore the king of Egypt rose up against them and dealt subtly with them and brought them low with laboring and brick and made them slaves. The same way in America. Then they cried unto their God, and he smote all the land of Egypt with incurable plagues. So the Egyptians cast them out of their sight. And the Most High dried the Red Sea before them and brought them to Mount Sinai in Kadesh Barnea and cast forth all that dwelt in the wilderness. So they dwelt in the land of the Amorites, and they destroyed by their strength all them at Eshbon, passing over Jordan, and they possessed all the hill country. It's getting to the point. And they cast forth before them the Canaanite and the Pherezite and the Jebusite and the Shittimite, you can't even say that one, and all the Girgashites that dwelt in the country many days. Let me get it. We about to get it, because it's the good part. We know you. We met you before.
What the?
Right here, right now. Tomorrow might not be here. Hey, let me get back to this juicy, man. I was getting right to the point. Mess me up, bro.
What's your name?
My camera gonna die, bro. Trying to get the whole story in. Kings of the Earth. I gotta get this in before my camera dies though, bro. But when they departed, listen, and whilst they sinned not before their God, they prospered. See, when Israel didn't sin, they prospered. Listen up, bro. I'm just gonna read it, because I got to get this out. Hey, we're going to talk about Israel right now, the real Israel. Because you came up right when I was in the middle of getting this in. All right? I didn't know, you know what I'm saying? Not trying to nothing against you. I just got to get this done. But listen. And whilst, this is talking about Israel. And whilst they sin not before their God, they prosper. See, when we don't sin, you prosper. Because the Most High that hateth iniquity was with them. But when they departed from the way which he appointed them, they were destroyed in many battles, very sore, and were led captives into a land that was not theirs. And the temple of their God was cast to the ground, and their cities were taken by the enemies. That's what happened to us, ain't it? But now they are returned to their God and are come up from the places where they were scattered. They go to Israel, because Israel was scattered many times. And have possessed Jerusalem, where the sanctuary is, and are seated in the hill country, for it was desolate. Now listen to what he told him. Now therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error in this people, and they sin against their God, let us consider that this shall be their ruin. And let us go up, and we shall overcome them. But if there be no iniquity in their nation, let my Lord now pass by, lest their Lord defend them and their God before them, and we become a reproach before all the world.
Yes.
That was a long one, but hey, that's a good point though, you see? And they gave me the history. I tell you, every time Israel had the Most High with them, they didn't destroy the heathens. You know, destroy them. Ran through them like they didn't want nothing.
I don't forget.
Judas.
You know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking about Maccabees.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's beautiful. When Judas had that, he was like a lion. Now we should get that.
I mentioned how the Lord fought full with him. It's bad, too. It's bad.
That was like one of the beautiful scriptures.
Let's see if I can find it.
guess that one said Judas was like a lion. Yeah, yeah, Judas, he was one of the top warriors of in history.
There you go. This is the second Mac of these 10 and 28. Now the sun being newly risen, they join both together, one part having together with their virtue their refuge also unto the Lord for a pledge of the success and victory, the other side making their rage leader of their battle. But when the battle waxed strong, there appeared unto the enemies from heaven five comely men upon horses with bridles of gold, and two of them led the Jew. He took Maccabeus betwixt them and covered him on every side with their weapons and kept him safe, but shot arrows and lightnings against the enemy. So that being confounded with blindness and full of trouble, they were killed. Now that's just another example of how they came down to help him.
Yeah, are you talking about the angels and all that?
Yeah.
Hey, there's a scripture that tell you in the Old Testament too. Wasn't when Joshua had angels with him. They don't say a man of the Lord guided him, was with him, and the angel was fighting with him. Can you imagine fighting with an angel with you, by your side, fighting with you?
How far you want?
I'm gonna look for Astro.
Second.
Maccabees is full.
Oh, man.
Second Chronicles 20 and 15. And he said, hearken ye, all Judah, and the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thou, King Joseph, that Thus saith Yahweh unto you, be not afraid nor dismayed, be by reason of the great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but the Most High's.
So that's where the strength comes from. The Lord just uses you as a producer,
man. I got just a little quick thing on Judas Maccabees about how brave a warrior he was. This is the first Maccabees, he's one of the greatest warriors that ever lived, you know what I mean? He was up there with King David, Joshua, you know what I mean? Samson. Hey look, Maccabees 3:1. Then his son Judas, called Maccabeus, rose up in his stead, and all his brethren helped him, and so did all they that held with his father, and they fought with cheerfulness in the battle of Israel. So they was happy to fight for Israel. So he got his people great honor and put on a breastplate as a giant and girt his warlike harness about him, and he made battles, protecting the host with his sword. In his axe, he was like a lion, and like a lion's whelp roaring for his prey. For he pursued the wicked and sought them out and burnt up those that vexed his people. Wherefore the wicked shrunk for fear of him, and all the workers of iniquity were troubled because salvation prospered in his hand. He grieved also many kings and made Jacob glad with his axe, and his memorial is blessed forever. That's a bad dude right there. You know what I mean? That's who we descend from. But, you know, you see all people now, they got that weak and feminine spirit. And they don't have that strong lion spirit. That's exactly what
they turn into a bunch of women, dude.
Exactly.
I'm not fine with these
two. I mean, they have everything.
Exodus 7:1. Yahweh said unto Moses, see, I have made thee a god to Pharaoh, and Aaron thy brother shall be thy prophet.
Aaron was a prophet. And they had superpowers too, Moses and Aaron.
Right.
You know what I mean? He turned a staff into a snake. He could do the same tricks that Moses could do. When Moses taught him how to do it. Did you watch the Exodus movie, Cecil B. DeMille's movie? And it showed in that movie that Moses was the one to put down the staff. And the scriptures tell you it was Aaron that did it. So they know, why would you need to lie about something so small?
They have to do that.
It's like they gassed the law. They can't
they
tell you the truth.
Right.
What'd you say? Yeah, well, Aaron was the mouthpiece of Moses because, you know, Moses had a hard time talking. He stuttered.
This is Joshua.
I think that's when I was about to get to it.
Joshua 10.
Sorry, I ain't got
Joshua 10 and 11. And it came to pass as they fled from before Israel and were in the going down to Beth Haran that the Lord cast down great stones from heaven upon them unto Azekah. And they died. They were more which died with hailstones than they whom the children of Israel slew with the sword.
Let her go. Just let us get this out.
Then spake Joshua to the Lord in the day when the Lord delivered up the Amorites before the children of Israel. And he said in the sight of Israel, Son, stand thou still upon Gibeon, and thou move in the valley of Ajon. Still sitting, both thy stuff, the sun where it was, the moon where it was. And the sun stood still. And the moon stayed until the people had avenged themselves upon the enemy. Is not this written in the book of Joshua?
And that proves that the sun goes around the earth.
So the sun stood still in the midst of heaven and has not to go down about a whole day. The sun was sitting for
his children.
It's sitting there. And there was no day like that before it or after it. That the Lord hearkened unto the voice of the man, and the Lord fought for Israel. Non-believers.
The Lord fought for him.
The Lord fought for Israel. So there's some motherfucking Jakes out there that's calling themselves atheists and shit. You know? There are fucking Jakes out there that's Satans.
Yeah.
You know? That don't believe, there's Jakes that will bug me out, they don't believe in nothing. They don't believe in the power of God.
You gotta be just totally gone to be like that.
You
this is obvious that you gotta believe that something's out there.
I mean,
you can't see that if you're just totally gone. You're just beyond stupid.
Two-thirds and grab yours then.
Hey, I got a scripture for that too, the people that don't believe it all.
He knows.
Psalms 14:1. The fool has said in his heart, there is no God. They are corrupt. They have done abominable works. There is none that doeth good. The Lord looketh down from heaven upon the children of men and see if there were any that didn't understand and seek God. They are all gone aside. They are all together become filthy. There is none that do good, no, not one. They tell you right, only a fool would say there ain't no God. You know what I mean? He gone, bro. He got PTSD. He got Stockholm syndrome. He got Stockholm PTSD, schizophrenia. What else? He's bipolar. He got it all. Something you gotta get him some lithium, bro. You know what I mean? He needs some lithium.
16 South High to Great Southern.
Sorry. We enjoyed though. We enjoyed the bad criticism.
Hey. Then they killed the 12 disciples. They killed the Lord. So, you know, we strive for it. You know, it fires us up. That's how we know we're doing the right thing. So, the majority of the people that come against it, somebody that's doing
it. I got a scripture.
If you're doing wrong, somebody can want to correct you, want to correct you. Most people take offense to that. They don't want to be told that they're doing wrong. That's one of our jobs, is to come out here doing it. Watch it. Some of the people that are doing wrong are changing their ways. That's called repent. You know what you were doing.
I was taught since I was in church when I was like five, and I was only taught Jesus Christ. And I took that information at the beginning, and I was
I got a script for it. This is why the people act the way they do. John 7 and 7. The world cannot hate you, but me it hateth, because I testify of it that the works thereof are evil.
That's why they don't like it. When you bring out all their evil bullshit, they don't want you talking about it.
If we can do that, we can prove a point. You know, people flock around
us. I'm always out here doing that preach, that feel good sermon. Thank the Lord for
water and sandwiches.
Oh yeah, you pass out sandwiches. Tell everybody to come, make you rich. You know, they love this dude. And we wearing nice suits. You know what I mean? Got the Rolex, pulled up in a clean shaven face, roll up in an Escalade. They
Six and 26. Woe to you when all men shall speak well of you.
Yeah, yeah. People speak good of you. There's something wrong. Go ahead.
For so did their fathers to the false prophets.
To the false prophets. Back in the old days, they didn't like it when the prophets came to town because they never had nothing good to say. What scripture is that? They always said the prophets always got the bad stuff to say. Like, why you always say the evil stuff? That's insane. Same deal with the person. That's right, it says before the, right at the beginning. That's before that episode.